Go ahead, count to 10. One.
Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10.
Very good.
Good job, buddy. Say, where are we from? Doylestown?
Doylestown, yeah.
Pennsylvania, right?
Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm. And Nicholas was diagnosed with brain cancer in November.
My name is Nydia Kavor, and in July, they found a tumor in my brain, and they found out it was like cancerous, so they wanted to do further treatment like radiation and chemo.
The amazing thing is, like, we all live our lives and we just go through the motions of what our expectations are going to be. And then suddenly, it can happen to any of us in the blink of an eye. Everything is upside down.
The first reaction is, you know, this is not right. We need someone. We need a second opinion. This can't happen to us. This stuff don't happen to us.
And by the time we got here, she could barely use her hand. She couldn't touch her fingers together. We spent a night while we were waiting to get in the CHOP at a local hotel, and they were very nice. It cost us $165.
Listen to all these monitors constantly going off at night, nurses popping in all the time, checking, you know, the monitors, checking pressures. She's 13 years old, you know, no doubt scared out of her mind, like her parents.
Remember, I started in oncology before there was much that we could do. I don't think anybody now would permit a child to bring his bunny in a cage and have it in the oxygen tent with him, in his live bunny. But if he wanted to bring his bunny in, it was all right for me.
And I meet this beautiful woman doctor, and her name's Audrey Evans, and I said, "Dr. Evans, I'm Jimmy Murray, and I'm from the Eagles." And she said, "What are they?" I said, "Excuse me, we're a bad football team. We're not very good." She said, "Well, do you know what happens when I tell a family their child has this disease? They don't hear one word I say. There's a 75% divorce rate, and it stresses a family out. So if we could get a YMCA, and we could have a place where parents could come, break bread together, talk to each other, that would be as good as all the medicine I'm giving their family."
Philadelphia Ronald McDonald House is a comfort zone. You can feel safe. You can feel love. You can feel understanding and support.
Our first impression, we pulled up out front because all we had was the address, and we pull up to this beautiful mansion, and they told us that the cost is $15 a night. If we couldn't afford it, other arrangements would be made for us.
A lot of times people visualize what it looks like in a hospital or in a doctor's office or in a dentist's office, and that's what they think that they're coming to. And then they come through our front doors and they realize that we're not a medical institution. In fact, we try to create an atmosphere that isn't medical in nature at all.
When you look in this house or look out that door and that statue's there, a kid's not afraid to walk through the door. I remember sitting out there one night, big van came up from Tennessee. I don't even know which kid was sick, but all those kids said, "He's in there."
And I said, "TV, wait."
And the TV, yep. And what else?
And I said, "A bed."
The comfy beds.
Beds.
Why are the beds so good?
Because we sleep.
Because we sleep in them.
You like sleeping?
There is no place quite like us in terms of being home. My son always loved coming here. He still says, "Are we going to the Ronald McDonald House?"
Well, I go downstairs and I see Cookie Monster and then see the trains.
You can feel it as you walk through the door. Somebody sees there and smiles at you, say, "How can I help you?"
And I really, truly felt at home when I got here.
A bunch of dogs come here at night, and we can just play with them, and it's really nice.
That feeling of love that you get when you walk in the doors, it's amazing, and it's really a blessing. Seeing the kids play together, no matter what their medical situation was, It just evened the playing field for everybody.
It hits home for me because in 1965, I was, at the time, the youngest person in the country who ever had reconstructive carotid artery surgery. And I couldn't even imagine what my parents went through in 1965, 9 years before the first house opened.
You can imagine what it would be like if you left the hospital, let's say at 7:30, 8 o'clock at night, had to go back to a hotel, had to find something to eat, had to find somewhere to do your wash, had to find somebody to talk to. It would be practically impossible. We take care of all that here. The opportunity to do all those things is right here.
Another one of the amazing things was this piano, because Joseph was an amazing athlete. Once he got sick and he wasn't able to do the normal things in his life, he didn't get angry about it. He just diverted his talents in another direction, and lo and behold, he taught himself how to play the piano. And he wrote songs. And he used to come downstairs in the lobby here and just play the piano.
I used to cry a lot. And sometimes I would lock myself in the room. And they would come knocking at my door. And they would just talk to me and listen to me.
You have to be emotionally involved in the lives of these people to respond to not only to a crisis, but to joy and a birthday. I mean, you only need to have a birthday here, and it's a riot.
One of the best moments at the Ronald McDonald House that makes all of us laugh is when we have patients living with us that are running around and getting into trouble. Normally, you would want to stop and say, hey, put your shoes on, or hey, stop throwing that, or why is everyone running around in a circle? And then you take a step back and you say, wow, these kids are being normal because they feel comfortable and they're at the Ronald McDonald House.
To just walk in here, meet the staff, meet the volunteers, meet the families, and you'll be hooked just like I was.
And an enormous amount of volunteers that are here every single day. We have guest chefs that cook every single night.
I had an experience with my daughter a long time ago where she ended up at CHOP, and we were frightened, and we spent some time there, and they finally got her well again. But while I was there and we stayed in the hospital, there was no Ronald McDonald House then, I decided that if I could ever help somebody in that situation, I would, because I saw so many folks who were just devastated by what was going on.
I started volunteering 13 years ago at the Philadelphia Ronald McDonald House from 6 to 9 every Sunday night, and I drove the van. I drove the families in the van, and I found that it was the most rewarding 3 hours of my entire week.
My name's Brandon, and I'm the youngest one by 8 minutes. I don't let them use that against me. Well, yeah, we were born and raised in Philly, and I guess since our junior year, we've been volunteers, dynamic duel.
I saw that there was a need for transportation for the families to go back and forth to the hospitals. We decided to give 2 vans every 2 years to the house, and we've done that for 30 years now, and my only regret is that I didn't do it 10 years previous.
My grandchild, she's doing great. She's a happy baby. And her name is Faith.
I mean, I don't know if they'll ever, fully understand how much this place meant to us, you know?
And this is our little Frankie.
Say hi.
Years is a great milestone. When we think about Dr. Evans, Jimmy Murray, McDonald's, Eagles, opening up the first house at 4032 Spruce and it being 7 bedrooms, and how over time we've expanded not only one house but 2 and expanded our other programs and now serve 65 families every night. and that there are over 300 Ronald McDonald Houses worldwide. What an extraordinary accomplishment.
It's been a privilege to be standing next to these people and walking there with them, and they're so inspiring.
You can't come here and ever be the same, whether you stay for a night, a day, or the rest of your life.
My name is Ian Canterin. I attended the Ronald McDonald Camp for 12 years, first as a camper and then as a CIT. Now I'm 19 years old and I'm studying at the University of Rhode Island and playing Ultimate Frisbee.
We are the Bateman family, and we have been coming to the Philadelphia Ronald McDonald House since 2009.
Hi, my name is Megan Mann. My parents stayed here for 4 months in 2002.
Hi, we're the Becoses, Jeff, Liz, and Haley.
We feel absolutely blessed to have had the comfort and support of the Philadelphia Ronald McDonald House during the most difficult time of our lives.
I'm Riley Smith. I'm a current patient.
I'm Seth McDonald. I'm 15 years old. I'm from Muscle Shoals, Alabama.
Hi, I'm Frank.
I'm Jessica.
This is Jeremy.
My name is Kevin Vargas, and I want to thank the Ronald McDonald House for supporting me and my family in 2008.
My name is Peter Grossens, and I've stayed at the Philadelphia Ronald McDonald House annually for the past 10 years.
And now I'm a senior in college. I'm going to go to grad school for neuroscience.
And we want to thank you all from the bottom of our heart.
Right now I am studying at Millersville University, hoping to become a child life specialist at CHOP.
My name is Regina Maguire. I'm 16 years old, and I've been staying at the Ronald McDonald House for a little over a month.
Here's to another 40 years of the Ronald McDonald House.
Thank you. Bye-bye now.
Hold on to me as we go. As we roll down this unfamiliar road, and although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.